What's up, everybody? It's King Kunta, and today I have another World of Warcraft gold farm for you guys today. And as you can probably tell, where we're at in the video right now, we are actually at Black Rock Spire. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys that don't know exactly where that's at, so you guys can figure out where the farm is. So today we're in Burning Steeps at the entrance of Black Rock Mountain right now, which is in the Eastern Kingdoms. If you're Alliance, it's literally like it'd take you 2 minutes to fly here. If you're Horde, you're gonna have to take a flight path from the Undercity, and that's probably the easiest way to get here. And yeah, that's really all you need to know. So today we're gonna be farming the raid known as Molten Core. Now, some of you may have heard of this raid before because it is basically infamous for gold farmers. And one of the few reasons why is because some of the items that drop there. And they're actually some of the
Our enemies
most
will fall.
popular and or rare items in the game.
Remember the sun.
So if we go ahead and we enter Black Rock Mountain, we entered right from the entrance as you saw, and once we get in here, the dungeon, or not dungeon, sorry, raid we want to go to is kind of quite tricky because it's not really shown exactly where it's at in the beginning. But if we look here, it doesn't even show it on the map, so it's kind of confusing. When you walk in, you just have to fly right here. So you come through this gate, and you just fly right here. And this entrance is a little bit different than normal raids. You actually have to talk
The
to this
eternal
NPC here and
sun
ask him to
guides us.
teleport you to the Molten Core, because there used to be attunement where they had to make sure you're
Keep your wits
readied
about
and
you.
all that good stuff. But as soon as you talk to him, he will let you enter the Molten Core. So give me
The
one
dark
second.
times will pass.
And yes, you can't be mounted. So this farm is good for three reasons, and three reasons only really, and one reason actually I was not aware of until actually another YouTuber by the name of Sharkin actually uploaded a video on it himself, which I had never thought to do. So just so you know, I got this video idea from Sharkin, and also look at that, my thing's glitching out like completely. That's so weird. Okay, that was weird. But so as we see when we first walk in, there's a bunch of mobs. So these mobs all have chances to drop epic loot, but also so do the bosses, so you're gonna want to kind of farm everything. So first things first, the one item we're kind of really like praying for, really, I don't want to say like expecting to get, but kind of praying for, is actually Tibu's Blazing Longsword. If you guys don't know what that is, it's actually one of the rarest RNG items in the game, and it actually does have a chance to drop from Molten Core, which is actually pretty cool. And if you do get the item to drop, you are going to make about $1 million, or 1 million gold, sorry, in World of Warcraft, which is pretty good, if you ask me. I definitely recommend you come farm this now. Also, the next thing we have is actually called Blood of the Mountain, which is actually a vanilla mat for crafting back in the day, and it actually creates some quite cool transmog please or pieces now, so it definitely sells in the auction house. And then the last thing we're going to be farming is actually sorry about that, dark iron ore, which spawns all throughout this entire dungeon. The video I learned from Sharkin, another fellow YouTuber, actually showed me about a add-on called Gathermate, which actually shows you all the nodes that spawn within the dungeon of this ore. And this ore right now is going for about 200 a piece on my server. So on your server, if you actually have auctions up, you can probably expect the ore to end up being around 50 gold a piece, I think is around the average for most servers. And really, all you have to do is have mining, and you just kind of run around and loot all the nodes because they will be shown on your map, so you'll know exactly where they're at. As you can see, I actually just got Blood of the Mountain, so I can show you exactly how much that is worth. And also, I got a Lava Core, which happens to sell in the auction house as well. And sorry about that, I had to kill all these first before TSM will actually show me the item of that. And as you can see, oh, I killed that last one. There we go. Okay, so Blood of the Mountain right now is going for about 4,000 on my server, so you can kind of see how well that actually is doing. And let me see if I can find our other mat in here. I don't know, somewhere. There it is. Lava Core, it's going for about 1 gold, so you can actually sell those on the auction house as well. But remember, the main thing we want is ghost or dark iron dwarf or sorry about that. It's really easy to find if you don't have Gathermate, but I definitely recommend installing the add-on Gathermate. I will have a link in the description below to Gathermate if you want to install it. I actually have installed it I want to say, after this video goes up, because I didn't know about it until now, and now I know, so I've been farming this dungeon with it, basically religiously from now, you know, at the time you're seeing this. And that's really it about this dungeon. You kind of just want to go in, pick up everything, trash run it, and that's really all there is to it. There is no one easy way to farm this mob for trash. If you want to go about the most simple, easiest way to kill everything, it's really just follow this path that I'm showing you, because it has the most mob density and boss density, so you actually have a chance of getting some quite good gear just from running that, if you don't want to run the entire thing. But I do recommend you run the entire thing, because I've seen people come out with just tons and tons of gold. I personally take this path right here, because really I'm kind of just trying to get some of the rare transmog pieces dropped, because I'm mainly kind of a transmog seller, but also in the same fact I also don't have mining yet. But you can actually mine the iron ore in this farm at level 1. It won't level up your mining, but you actually will get, you know, have the ability to mine the ore that is in here, which is really all you need. You don't really need to level up mining, unless you're going to use it for BFA, which I recommend you do, so maybe do level up mining. But that's really it for this farm. I kind of explained everything to you guys, and if you have any questions, just let me know in the comment section below. I am actually going to cut the video now, and we're going to go to one of the major cities. I'm just going to explain what you can do with all this drops you get from here, and what they're used for, and just good stuff like that. So check out that at the end of the video if you want to. And also, I always leave like any little hints and tips and tricks for after I cut the video, so if you want to check those out, you stay tuned and you can get all those. And yeah, that's really it. So yeah, I'm gonna cut the video now, and we'll see you after that. And also, make sure you check out the links in the description. I have to plug myself, I'm sorry, because I'm a YouTuber and this is how it is, but I love you all, and I cut the video now. Everybody, we're back after that cut, and now I'm just gonna kinda explain why we needed to farm some of the items, and what exactly you can do with them to make them worth more money for you, and yeah, basically just all that good stuff, and also the add-ons that you guys need as well, also just to make your life easier. So first things first, the one item that we were looking for in the dungeon was actually Tibu's Blazing Longsword. So we're gonna look that up just on my server, just to show you guys what the price is. As you can see, the price on my server is extremely volatile. As you can see, people are like trying to undercut each other and stuff. But if this on your server is literally like anything less than 100,000 gold, I'd be like very surprised, because it's quite a hard item to obtain RNG wise, and this is a very good transmog piece that sells off quite quickly if you're actually able to get one of them to drop. As you can see, these prices are kind of representative of most servers. I think most of them actually end up like this after people start trying to farm the item, because they start dropping and people are undercutting and all that good stuff. After I post this video, prices might change on yours, though, just so you know, because a lot more people are going to start farming this, so keep that in mind. You may want to go farm this now. Just again, as a warning, you guys probably already know, but just letting you know. Also, the second item that we were looking for was the Blood of the Mountain, which we will show you real quick. Blood of the Mountain is actually a crafting reagent, where you're able to craft some of like the oldest mats in the game into gear, and a lot of people do that because this is required to make a lot of transmog gear. So if you have something like a tailor or something, go ahead and check and make sure you don't have any patterns that, you know, you should be. So on my server right now, one is going for like at least 2700 gold, which is quite good. And it has an 8% chance to drop every time you run Molten Core, so normally you end up with about 2 or 3 of these out of Molten Core anyways. And these actually do sell off a little bit quicker than the rest of the mats, just because they're much easier to come by. Also, the last item that I mentioned was Dark Iron Ore, which on my server... you guys have seen this video now before I farmed it, obviously, because right now this is my market and there is only one guy selling it. So if your market looks like this, go do this farm instantly, because you're able to just buy up whatever he has and charge whatever price you want, especially at the average sell rate, daily sold 21. So people are still looking for these, and this guy's only got two. So as you can see here, Just so you know, you're watching this now, but I have farmed the crap out of this now, and now my auction house is probably all the way down here. Yeah, so if you ever see this on your auction house, especially with a daily sold, even if the daily sold's at least 10 and there's only one guy posting stuff, buy his out and just go farm it yourself, because you'll be able just to make tons of gold off of it. That's also one of the little tricks. I don't know if they teach you in World of Warcraft, but that's definitely something you should be doing as well. And yeah, that's really it. So if you did like the video, just leave me a like, comment, subscribe. Maybe, I guess if you really liked it, subscribe. Also, make sure you check out the links in the description below, because you can buy Battle for Azeroth for the cheapest anywhere on the internet right now. You can look below, get that. Also, I've got all the links to my computer gear, hardware, like everything from software to good stuff. So if you thought maybe starting a YouTube channel, you guys actually have a list of everything that I use basically to get decent graphics on World of Warcraft. And yeah, so you guys might like that. Anyways, that's gonna be it for this video. And I may or may not have another one coming out tomorrow. I mean, wink wink. And if you stayed to this point in the video, comment down below. Let's think of something funny. What should we make you comment? You have to comment Kappa down below if you watch to this point. And I'll favorite your comment because, or like it or something, or shout it out or whatever, because you're an OG. You actually like all of my content. So, I'm gonna cut the video, and thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.